Subscribe to Grazia and press on the bell icon.
Hi everyone, I'm Tara Sotaria and I'm shooting for the December cover of Grazia. The funniest thing that has happened to me recently is I was hosting a dinner party at home. And I'm a very, very, very clumsy person, unfortunately. And I was just running from my terrace into my living room, going to welcome a guest with my arms wide open, and I didn't see the door was shut. And I have run straight into the glass. And despite getting almost a fractured nose, I fell down and I got back up and I was like, hi, welcome. So that was quite funny. I actually have tons of very weird nicknames since I was a baby. My parents used to call me Tarabu, Tar Bear, Squishy, Fluffy, all kinds of names like that, which I quite like. And we still use in our home and with my friends. But I think if I could choose a nickname, it would be Fluffy only. I love Fluffy. In my household, we eat tons and tons of food. Our conversations at the dinner table and the lunch table are always about food. So I think in my fridge you'll find tons and tons of cold cuts. You will find lots and lots of chocolate. You will find a couple of sodas, some Diet Cokes and things like that, and lots of sweetmeats as well. Lots of food, basically. The most interesting holiday, I think all of my holidays have been really, really interesting, but I think the one that trumps my list would be when I went to Japan and when I went to Kashmir, two places that are very, very, very close to my heart. I performed in both of them. I sang, I had concerts, so for me it was really, really special to be in Japan. I had never been before. I was only, I think, 17 years old when I went to Japan. I performed in Tokyo. That was really interesting to just see the culture and the vibrancy that just all of the people have, and you know, whether it's the trees, the flora, the fauna, it's just so stunningly beautiful. And even in Kashmir, it was such a special experience for me to just connect with that part of our country and to sing for such fine people. It was really wonderful for me. In a perfect world, communication would have no judgment, no biases, a lot more kindness and a lot more love, a lot more understanding for our differences. And I think our communication should probably have just a lot more deep-rooted sensitivity towards each other. I think that would be communication in a perfect world. The most ridiculous fact I know, okay, let me think. When I was a kid, I used to read a lot of these amazing fact books. So I used to find it really, really fun. I think a random fact I can tell you is the can opener or the tin opener was invented 80 years after cans were invented. Why? We will never know. Oh my gosh, if I had my own talk show, my first three guests would be the very, very strong women in my life. My nani, my mom, and my twin sister. Well, for any six-year-old child watching this, I grew up believing in Santa, and I think it's really important to believe in the things you want to believe in. So you believe in Santa and you believe in all the beautiful things in the world. Christmas is a very, very, very special occasion in my house, and I'm sure it is in so many homes all over the world. So if you believe in Santa, please believe in Santa.